Hello everyone and welcome back to Engineering Online. We are back with another amazing tutorial of Proteus series. In this tutorial, I would be controlling LED with Android app. To do the task, you would be needing a PC in which Proteus software is installed, Arduino IDE is installed, and you would be needing an internet connection to develop the application online and an Android phone to test the application. So if you want to know how to install the Arduino IDE and Proteus software, I have already uploaded a tutorial regarding the installation of both software, so you can find the video links in the description box. So moving on, the whole tutorial is divided into following sections. First of all, I will draw the circuit on the Proteus simulator. Then I will write the code on Arduino IDE. And then I will develop the app online on the MIT App Inventor. And last but not the least, I will install the app on phone and control the LED connected to the Arduino. Since this LED is Bluetooth controlled, so you need a Bluetooth module in the circuit. In Proteus simulator, its library is not present by default, so we have to download it. From the engineering projects website, download the Bluetooth module library. I will add the link of this website in the description too. So once the library is downloaded, extract the folder from the zip file. You will find these two files in the folder with .idx and .lib extension. Copy both of them and go to the main Windows folder of your PC and open Program Files 86. Find the Lab Center Electronics folder and then Proteus 8 Professional. And open the library folder and paste these two files here. Now open Proteus software and click on the P tag to add the components. So first of all, I am adding Arduino Uno here. And then write Bluetooth in the search bar. It shows two different Bluetooth modules, HC05 and HC06. I am selecting the first one. Now type resistor in the search bar and add a resistor. And now type LED and select an LED. So all the required components have been added. Let's wire them now. There are only two usable pins of Bluetooth module, that is transmit and receive. Connect its receive pin with the transmit pin of Arduino and connect its transmit pin with the receive pin of Arduino. Now connect the 330 ohm resistor with the pin 13 of Arduino and then connect LED in series with it and connect its other pin with the ground terminal. Before moving ahead, do one thing, turn on the Bluetooth connection of your PC and open its setting and check the COM port of the Bluetooth connection. Now go back to the circuit and make sure that the same port is selected in the Bluetooth module also. So wiring is completed now, it's time to write the code on Arduino IDE. In the compiler settings, make sure that the correct Arduino board is selected and same Bluetooth port is also selected here. So in the coding, a string has been initialized here with the name text and this string will save the information received from the Bluetooth connection. In the setup function, mode of the pin 13 is defined as output and then initialize the serial connection. Now in the loop function, if the serial data is available, read the data in the variable text and display the text on the serial monitor also. So if the text is on, then turn on the LED and if the text is off, then turn off the LED. So the program is quite simple, now compile it and if there are any syntax errors then remove it. Once the compilation is completed, expand the output tab and search for the location of hex file. Copy this location and go back to the Proteus and paste it on the Arduino board. Now it's time to develop the Android application. We would be developing this application online. Write MIT App Inventor in the Google search bar and open the website. Make your account on the website and start a new project. So if you have not worked on it before, let me just give you a quick introduction of the website. This website allows you to develop an Android application without even writing a single piece of code. It has two main tabs, that is designer and block. In the designer tab, you would be designing the front end of the app. and in the block tab you would be connecting the blocks rather than writing the code. So let's first design it and then I would be switching to the block section. This is the screen of application. I am defining the basic features of this app like its alignment and its title. So now I am adding the image from the user interface and setting its features like height and width. Now let's add a list picker now. Change its color of your own choice, its size, its height, its width and text on it. Next, I am adding a horizontal arrangement block from the layout tab and change its properties. Now add a button in it and change its color of your own choice and write the text on it. I am adding another button here too. Do the same changes with it also. Next, I am adding a label here and designing it accordingly. So when the Bluetooth connection is established, only then this label would be visible. So I have unchecked its visibility, but it would be displayed in the viewer. Next, I am adding another image that is logo of the channel. Next, I am adding another button here to disconnect if needed. Change its text, height, width, color, etc. I am hiding its visibility too. It would only appear when the Bluetooth connection is established. So now let's switch to the blocks tab. Click on the list picker and select the before picking tab. Wait, I forgot to add the Bluetooth connection here. That is highly needed. So from the connectivity, add the Bluetooth client here. So now the elements of the list picker have been set to all the available Bluetooth connections and their addresses. Next block is about after selecting the connection. So let's add a if then condition here, and if the Bluetooth connection is established and picked from the list, then label 1 would become visible, showing that the Bluetooth is connected, and the disconnect button would also become visible. Next, when the user clicks on the button, we have to add the condition that what would happen. Add the if then condition here too. If the Bluetooth connection is established, then a text saying on would be sent via Bluetooth and it would be displayed on the serial monitor. Now do the same programming for the off button too. And when the off button is pressed, the text saying off would be sent via Bluetooth. And in the end, the disconnect button is pressed. The Bluetooth connection is disconnected, and both label 1 and disconnect button would have been disappeared. So the programming has been completed. It's time to build the application. Click on the build and then app. It would provide a barcode for the mobile to scan. Now go to the Play Store on your phone and type MIT AI2 Companion and download this app. And either type the 6 character code or scan the QR code. After scanning, it will prompt you to download the application and then install it. It's time to test the application. Play the simulation button on the Proteus and select the Bluetooth of your PC. And here it is, we are finally able to control the LED in the simulation software. Now you can implement it with the real hardware also, and you can expand this project and control some other appliances too. Must give it a try and give me your feedback in the comment section. Do press the like button if the tutorial has been beneficial for you. Share it with your fellows too. And don't forget to subscribe the channel so you don't miss out on a new upload of the series. You can also connect with us on Facebook and Instagram. Links are provided in the description. Thank you so much for watching. I will see you next time with the new tutorial.